Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_030_DIADWI you saved it. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. This will bring the save drawing as dialog box. If you plan to open this file in earlier version of AutoCAD, go to the file of type and change from AutoCAD 2018 and select that version. I'm going to select AutoCAD 2007. Rename this file to 00_031_DIAB. Click the save button to save the file. Now go to the quick access toolbar and make sure that the drafting and annotation workspace is the current workspace. If you don't have the workspace in your quick access toolbar, click this down arrow and place a check mark next to the workspace. You can also go at the bottom of the status bar and click and change, set the drafting annotation as the current workspace. Look at the ribbon. If you don't have the 3D tools tab, right click in the empty area and select show tabs and place a check mark next to the 3D tools tab. Now hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Today we're going to construct a railing for our staircase. Now select this slab, the stairs, this temporal line and this line. Right click and select isolate objects. AutoCAD hide all the objects except the object that you select. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. Zoom in into this area. At specify start point prompt, I've got the mouse cursor into this area. Now move the cursor. If your cursor leave a plus sign where you have it previously, type 2 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Now move the mouse cursor down and use the perpendicular object snap. Click to place the line. Move the mouse cursor and use the perpendicular object snap again and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Press enter to start the line command again. At the specified first point prompt, hover the mouse cursor into this vertex and move slowly to the left. The cursor will leave a plus sign where you have it previously. Now type 2 inches on your keyboard and press enter. AutoCAD start the line 2 inches from the point where you have your mouse cursor previously. Now use the perpendicular object map to continue at the specified next point. Prompt. Click and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Now let's start to draw a line from this point to this point. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. At the specify first point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and click. At the specify next point or undo, go on the status bar and turn off the overview mode. Now move your mouse cursor and snap into this point. Go to the status bar and turn on the overview mode again. Move the mouse into this direction. When you see the perpendicular object snap, type 2 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Now move to the right and type 4 inches. Press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Hold down your shift key and orbit. Go to the home tab, draw panel and start the line command again. At the specified first point prompt, hover the mouse cursor into this area. Now move the mouse cursor in this direction. AutoCAD leave a temporal plus sign where you have all the cursor previously, an idiotic line follow the cursor. Now type 2 inches on your keyboard and press enter. AutoCAD start the line 2 inches from that point. Now move the mouse cursor and hover the mouse cursor into this area. Go to the status bar and turn off the auto mode. Hover the mouse cursor into this vertex and move the cursor away from this direction. Type 2 inches on your keyboard, press enter. Go to the status bar and turn on the auto mode. Move down and use the perpendicular object snap to snap and move the mouse cursor into this direction. Hover the mouse cursor into the endpoint of this line. Now move away and hover the mouse cursor here. Move away. When you get the temporal intersection, click. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the drop down arrow and turn the 3D walls to. Click into the drawing area to close the drop down window. Now zooming into this area and see how the temporal line works with this wall. Now we know that this line aligns with this wall perfectly. So next, go to the Home tab, Layer panel, and select the click the down arrow. Select the previous command. Auto guide place you to the previous state of the layer. Go to the visual style control and click the realistic. Select 2D wireframe. Now select this line. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the copy command. At the specified base point prompt, zoom in into this area and snap on this vertex. At the specified second point prompt, move into this vertex and snap. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the fillet command. Select this line and this line. Press escape. Zoom in into this area and select the fillet command again. Select this line and this line. Let's try to check the relationship between where this line meets and this vertex. To do that, go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the line command. At the specified base point prompt, use the mouse cursor and arrow to this area. Now move the mouse cursor until right click. I don't want you to guess. Right click and select the perpendicular objects now. That way, only the perpendicular objects now can be active. Click. Press escape to get out of command. So we need to join this line and this line. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. Select this line and this line. Press escape. Now select this line and erase it. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the line command. At the specified first point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and start a line here. Move to the vertical direction, the positive Z axis. Turn on your OVO mode if your OVO is not on. Type 32 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Press enter to end line command. Now select this line. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the copy command. At the specified base point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and snap into the endpoint of this line. At the specified second point prompt, snap to the endpoint of this line, this line, this line. Zoom in and out to get to the right position. Snap into this line and this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2 inches on your keyboard and press enter. At the select object to offset prompt, select this 3D polyline and offset it into this direction. Press escape to get out of command. Now we are going to run railing on this line, so we need to know the relationship between this line and the wall that run along in this area. To do that, let's plot the 3D wall 2 layer. That way you can see the relationship clearly. Go to the layer panel and click the down arrow. Click this snowfall button to draw the 3D wall 2. Click into the drawing area to collapse the drop down window. Go to the visual style control and click 2D wireframe. Select realistic. Now hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Yeah, the line worked perfectly for us. Now go back to the layer panel and click the drop down arrow after layer. Select previous. AutoCAD return you to the previous state of the layer. Hold down your middle mouse button and orbit to get a better orientation like this. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the trim command. At the select object or select all prompt, press enter. Trim off this line and this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Hold down your shift key and orbit around. Right click the UCS and select the face option. Select this face, press enter to accept. Go to the visual style control, click realistic, select 2D wireframe. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the line command. At the specified first point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and snap at the endpoint of this vertical line. At the specified next point on B, click on this endpoint. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. At the specified offset distance prompt, type 4 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it down. Press escape. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 5 inches and press enter. Select this line, offset it down, Select this line, type 1 inch and press enter. Select this down, offset it down. Select this down, type 1 inch and press enter. Select this line, offset it down. Select this line, type 1 inch and press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 0.5 inches, press enter. For the offset distance, zoom into the area, offset this line down, this line, and select this line, move up, type 1 inch on your keyboard and press enter. Press escape to get out of the corner. Now select this line, this line, this line, and hit delete this cut on your keyboard. Select this line, this line, this line, this line, hit delete on your keyboard. Hold down the shift key and use the mouse button to orbit around. Select these lines. Use a cursing window select to select all of this line. Orbit around. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At a specified base point, use the endpoint object snap to copy from this base point. Now, move your mouse cursor and copy this line into this area. Move the mouse cursor and copy this line into this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Select these lines. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At a specified base point front, select this line and copy it into this vertex. Select this line, copy it into this vertex. This line and copy it into this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the visual style control and click the 2D wireframe. Select realistic. Go to the home tab and click the down arrow next to draw panel and select the 3D polyline command. At the specified start point form, start from this point. Move your mouse cursor and snap from this point. Snap from this point. This point. This point. This point. This point and this point. Press escape to get out of the command. Zoom in into this area, select these poly lines and erase them. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At the select object prompt, select this 3D polyline. Press enter. At the specified base point prompt, select this line, copy it into this area. This area, this area, press escape to get out of the command. Select the 3D polyline again. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. At the specified base point prompt, click on this area and move the mouse cursor to the Z direction. Make sure that your Odo mode is on. Type 1 inch on your keyboard and press enter. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the circle command. At the specified center point of a circle, click anywhere in the drawing, move the mouse cursor and type 1 inch, press enter. Press enter again to repeat the circle command. Click anywhere in the drawing, move the mouse cursor and type 0.5, press enter. Select this circle. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At the specified base point prompt, click on this circle. Copy it into three places. Press escape. Press enter to repeat the copy command. At the select object prompt, select this circle. Press enter. At the specified base point prompt, click on the circle and copy it to the second place. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the 3D tools tab and select the sweep command. At the select object to sweep prompt, select the bigger circle. At the select object to sweep from press enter. At the select sweep path or align, at the select sweep path prompt, select this 3D polyline. Press enter to repeat the command again. At the select object to sweep prompt, select the circle, press enter. At the select path prompt, select this top 3D polyline. Press enter to repeat the sweep command. At the select object to sweep prompt, select the circle, press enter. At the select path prompt, select this object. Press enter to repeat the sweep command again. Continue until you complete all the railings. Go to the 3D model tab and click the down arrow under box and select the sphere. At the specified center of the sphere prompt, move the mouse cursor and click the end point of this line. At the specified radius or diameter prompt, type 2 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Change your visual style to 2D wireframe. Select the sphere, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. At the specified base point prompt, use the endpoint of this line as the base point. Turn off your oval mode. Now move into this area and snap to the endpoint of this line, endpoint of this line, endpoint of this line, this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the visual style control and select and change it back to realistic. Right click the UCS and select world. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the circle command. At the specified start point of the circle, click into this area. At the specified radius of the circle, type 1 inch and press enter. Select the circle, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. At the specified base point prompt, move the mouse cursor and click at the center of the circle. At the specified second point or array prompt, type A on your keyboard and press enter for the array option. At the enter number of item to array prompt, enter 7, press enter. Turn on the auto mode on your keyboard. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Press enter to exit the command. Go to the 3D tools tab and select the sweep command. At the select object to sweep prompt, select this circle. At the select path prompt, select this line. Press enter to repeat the sweep command. Select this circle, press enter and select this line. Press enter to repeat the command again. Select the circle, press enter and select this line. If we sweep another line here, it will be look awkward. So let's select this sphere and this sphere, hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel and select the sweep command. At the select object to sweep prompt, select this circle, press enter. At the select path prompt, select this path. Press enter to repeat the sweep command again. Select this object, press enter and select this path. Go to the home tab, layer panel and click the layer property. This will bring the layer properties manager. Click the new button to create a new layer. Name this layer railing. Click the color switches. This will bring the selected color dialog box. Click the color book. Click this down arrow and select painting metallic coated. Scroll down and look for a suitable color for your railing. I'm going to select painting 8503C. Click OK. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the railings and go to the home tab, layer panel and click the down arrow. select the railing layer. Press escape to get out of the corner. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. Select the railing. Select this object, this solid, 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 and this solid. Let's escape to get out of the corner. Go to the home tab layer panel and click the down arrow. Tour the 3D wall to see how your layer works with the model. Hold down the shift key and middle mouse button to edit around. Go to the home tab, layer panel and select the isolate command. Select one of these temporal lines and press enter. Use a window selection to select all of these temporal lines and delete them. Go to the home tab, layer panel and click the on isolate button. Then right click in the drawing area, isolate and object isolation. Go to the layer panel again and click the tool button. This will bring your entire model. Now let's hide the roof to see the relationship between the slab, the stairs, the railing and the entire model. Go to the home tab, layer panel and click the freeze layer button. Select this roof, press escape, orbit around to see the relationship in the railing. There is one thing more we need to do. We need to get an opening for the cutting wall. But first, let's draw a reference line for the cutting wall. Select the attic wall and the cable. Right click, isolate, hide object. Click the left face of the view cube to see the relationship of the wall and the fascia board. Now go to the home tab, drop and select the line command. Draw a temporal line across the screen. Press escape to get out of the corner. Now hold down the shift key and middle mouse button to orbit. This line can help you to understand the relationship between the fascia board and the wall. Select the temporal line that you just draw. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. At the specified base point form, use the object snap and click at the end point of this line. Now move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 25 inches on your keyboard, press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, layer panel and select the freeze command. Freeze the fascia board. Freeze the soffit. Press escape to get out of the panel. Now select this line and delete it. So this red reference line can help us understand the relationship between the fascia board and the wall. Hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit around. Type DI on your keyboard and press enter. Now I'll try to check the distance from this point to this point. The distance is 7 feet 6. We want our cutting wall to be 6 feet 3. So let's deal with the width first. To do that, go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. At the specified base point form, zoom in into this area and click. Move the mouse cursor. When you see the perpendicular object, snap, click. Now move the mouse cursor. 8 feet 7 minus 6 feet is 1 foot 6. 1 foot 6 divided by 2 is 9 inches. Now type 9 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Move the mouse cursor down and snap perpendicular to the slab. Or just move it down and click. Right click the UCS and select face option. As the select face of solid, surface or mesh, hover the mouse cursor into this face and click. Press enter to accept. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At the select object point, select this line. Press enter. At the specified base point point, select this line. Now move the mouse cursor into this direction. Make sure that your auto mode is turned on. Type 6 switch on your keyboard and press enter. AutoCAD offset the line. Press escape to get out of the corner. Now go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the press pull command. Hover the mouse cursor into this area and click. Now press this object inside. Type 6 switch on your keyboard and press enter. Press escape to get out of the corner. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the press pull command. Hover your mouse cursor into this area. Click. Move the cursor down and type 1 foot on your keyboard. Press enter. Go to the visual style control. Click the realistic. Select 2D wireframe. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the press pull command. At the select object or bounded face point, click on this face. At the specified height of extrusion point, move down and snap to the edge of the landing. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the visual style control, click the 2D wireframe, and select realistic. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit around. Select this line, hit delete on your keyboard. Select this line, hit delete on your keyboard. Right click into the drawing area, isolate end object isolation. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the third layer button. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. Alright, in this tutorial we'll learn how to grid railing. In the next tutorial we'll start design our windows. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.